Let us now calculate electric field strength due to a uniformly charged long metal cylinder. Here you can see the figure in which on a long metal cylinder some charge is given and the charge is distributed only on the outer surface with the charge density, uniform charge density sigma coulomb per meter square. As we already studied that in case of metal bodies, charge only reside on the outer surface. But as the charge is symmetrically distributed on the outer surface, the electric field which is originated from this metal cylinder will be in radially outward direction. For the clarity of picture, here we are showing the charges only on the left and right surface because in front there is a curved part on which also the equal surface charge density exists. So, in this situation, the electric field configuration which is originated from the surface appear that it is originating from its axis. So, here we can see that the electric field in the outer region will be exactly having similar configuration which exists due to a uniformly charged long thread as if it is kept on the axis of the cylinder. So, in the outside region at a distance x, if at point P we calculate the electric field E out, then we can write for outer region, this for x greater than r, we can write E outside can be given as 2k lambda by x, which was the electric field due to a long uniformly charged thread, where lambda is the linear charge density. And in this situation, linear charge density can be easily calculated as the charge present on unit length of the cylinder. The circumference of this unit length will be 2 pi r and length is 1 meter. In that situation, linear charge density lambda can be given as sigma, which is the surface charge density multiplied by the area of the unit length of cylinder, that is 1 into 2 pi r. If we substitute this lambda over here, this electric field in outside region can be written as 2k sigma into 2 pi r divided by x. And here if we substitute the value of k as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, the result will be, here you can see, the result will be sigma r divided by, in this situation if k is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 pi gets cancelled out. Will be sigma r by epsilon naught x. This will be the result which will be there. Now, in this situation, the same result can be applied to a situation when this is a hollow sphere which is uniformly charged with a charge density sigma coulomb per meter square. Because in case of hollow cylinder also, the charge will be there only on the outer surface. Now, in this situation, if we substitute the value of x equals to r, that is for the surface of the cylinder, here we can see that electric field on the surface of this metal cylinder can be given as sigma by epsilon naught. And for x less than r, for interior points, if we calculate, we can directly state that E inside a metal body is always 0. And the same results are also applicable for a hollow cylinder. And if we just plot a variation curve of electric field with distance, then we can say from x equals to 0 to its surface, electric field remains 0. And on surface, its value is sigma by epsilon naught. And then gradually it will drop over the relation that E is inversely proportional to x. This is a rectangular hyperbola for outside zone. So, just be careful about these results also.